As road infrastructure becomes digital, highway operators and cities are better able to manage traffic and prevent accidents. Everyone is talking about 5G and vehicle-to-everything, also known as V2X connections. In this video, we will show you the V2X ecosystem, how messages reach road users, and where 4G and 5G cellular services fit in. There's a buzz around 5G. Mobile operators are building the infrastructure to cover entire countries. While 5G and 4G coverage increases, we have to keep in mind that cellular networks were not planned with road safety in mind. For better coverage, bandwidth, and latency, mobile operators have to invest more into building networks. Road safety and traffic management features based on communication between participants also depend on the end user's devices. Vehicles and mobile phones need apps for messaging and for V2X. Mobile internet connections have to be active, and someone has to pay for them. So how can we guarantee that safety messages get to drivers and road operators can rely on them? Vehicles need pre-installed V2X electronics and software. We supply these to car manufacturers. They integrate V2X services and provide an interface to display the messages. An onboard V2X system can send and receive long-range V2X messages over 4G or 5G, and also handle short-range V2X messages sent directly between cars and roadside units. Short-range messages are essential for road safety to reach recipients quickly so they can respond to an unexpected situation immediately. Short-range messages can be either DSRC or CV2X. While these standards are not compatible with each other, both DSRC and CV2X short-range messages can work with 4G or 5G long-range messages. Where do 4G and 5G cellular networks fit into the V2X infrastructure? Cities and road operators deploy roadside units to send V2X messages to vehicles. RSUs can send DSRC, CV2X messages, or both in dual mode. Again, if we want to communicate with vehicles nearby, the RSU and low-latency V2X messages are the best choice. To communicate over a larger area, where there are no RSUs, we can send messages over the 4G or 5G network. With extra computing power, RSUs can even work on their own, automatically recognize events, and send V2X warnings. A network connection is required to remotely manage RSUs. 5G can connect an RSU to a network where fiber optics cannot be used. And there's another, completely different way to utilize 5G. A roadside unit with a strong optical network connection can host mobile network equipment and act like a 5G cell to enhance coverage while sending V2X messages. As you can see, V2X is a diverse ecosystem with solutions for different purposes. If you have any questions, feel free to contact our experts.